But what she can never forgive is the fact that no matter what god-awful time of day it is, the raven-haired lawyer, who's almost 50, always manages to look half her age. That is beyond forgiveness. Captain, Mitzi stands at the far end of the table.
Take a seat.
He gestures to the conference table.
We're discussing the Creeper case, and in particular the DNA evidence Tom pulled together.
Been discussing.
Sanchez shoots Matthews a courtroom look as she emphasizes the past tense. Mitzi just can't bring herself to sit alongside the lawyer. She takes a place opposite Matthews.
How can I help?
We're not going to prosecute James.
Matthews pauses to let the point sink in.
He's going to be committed into psychiatric care.
Sanchez clears her throat.
Captain, if your team can properly tie up James's confessions to the murders of Varley and Bass, Commissioner Bradley will make a public statement about those crimes being linked to James and explain he is not fit for trial. He'll also state publicly that you've now closed the Creeper files and are not looking for anyone else.
Matthews turns to Carter.
Public-wise, it has the same effect as winning the trial. Case closed.
The commissioner would like that.
Sanchez smiles.
It would also be done without any of the risk of improper disclosure of further cost to the taxpayer.
Carter looks furious.
By improper, you mean Tom's scientific evidence? Science American citizens have a right to know?
She waves a hand at him.
Don't be immature. 90% of them wouldn't understand if he visited them all in person and spent a day explaining it.
Why? Mitzi barks. Why are you trying to sweep all these findings under the carpet? Sanchez sighs.
You really have to think this through.
She gives Mitzi a condescending stare.
Think about the implications of full disclosure. If we go public, we risk arming defense attorneys nationwide with a new plea of genetic mitigation.
Bullshit. The word tumbles out of the lieutenant's mouth.
There are examples worldwide of fine, upstanding, law-abiding citizens, men, women, and children who are closely, never mind distantly, related to rapists, murders, and terrorists. They're not bad people. Their genes don't possess badness.
Mitzi's right, snaps Carter.
Bad people are bad because they make the choice to be bad. We can't open this can of worms.
Sanchez starts to pack her leather document case.
We're done discussing it.
Silence floats like a poison cloud. Mitzi reaches to the middle of the table, grabs a glass, and pours water from a jug.